to thank you, because there were many times that I asked this committee in the late hours or early morning calls, could you, would you please help? And no one said no, and I really, really want to thank you for that. I would like to briefly explain to you how the selection process came about this year for our two recipients. On the committee were myself as the chairperson, Mimi Baca, Ken Manning, Laura Lee Sorensen, Dick Anderson, Ron Becker, Sharon Money, and Gloria Turner. Now, these people are from different areas of the community. Mimi is a woman in business. Ken Manning is a past recipient. Laura Lee Sorensen was from our Cupertino School District. No, I take that back. She's also the school district, but also she's on our planning commission for the city of Cupertino. Dick Anderson, the principal in our Cupertino School District. Ron Becker, who's with the, oh my, Ron, are you with the Kiwanis or the Rotary? I get you too confused. At any rate, it was one of our service clubs. Sharon Money was an interested citizen in the community, and Gloria Turner is from the banking community. We had several nominees this year, and they were all very, very fine people that were nominated, and I have to admit it really was a very tough decision. But on the other hand, the two people that did win this award this year were chosen far and above everyone else. I'd like now to call to the podium Barbara Koppel, who is our lady recipient, and Spiro Rafalovich, who is a gentleman recipient for this year. Spiro are standing here, we would like now to present you with some awards. I'd like to call our president, Nicole Lee, to present the Chamber Awards. Nicole?
First of all, I would like to read a few of the accomplishments both Spiro and Barbara have done. I've known both of them. I had the pleasure of serving under Spiro's presidency term. I enjoyed it, learned a lot. And of course, Barbara, I know, is a dear, dear friend. When I was running for city council, she helped me a lot. In 1983, Barbara was recognized for her civic service contributions from the city of Cupertino. People who have worked with her have focused on her enthusiasm and high energy level. That superb spirit, let's put it that way, she never tires out. This lady's on the phone at 1 a.m. in the morning. Has enabled her to perform many public service activities in the community. Among them are, she was PTA president at Regnard Elementary School, where she initiated many fundraising drives, such as a holiday boutique, the home tour, the talent show, and the dime a dip dinner. So, also she was president again at Monta Vista High School and served as chairman of the accreditation committee for Monta Vista. Her most ambitious educational project was co-founding of the Fremont Union School District Foundation, known as Super Schools. In this capacity, she co-chaired the overall fundraising campaign and was responsible for soliciting Steve Wozniak to be the honorary chair and raised a hell of a lot of money. Active participation in the Cupertino, California Cupertino Soccer Club. She served as secretary in 81-82 and then later on became president. She also helped out with the snack shack operation for Saturdays. That's very important. That's where we served all the old hot dog buns from our activities. I'm only kidding.
It's a little in joke.
She also co-founded the West Cupertino Homeowners Association in 1980, a group that now has around 250 members. Also, she was instrumental in having a traffic survey done the same year when Highway 85 corridor was to be abandoned. That's only 5 years ago, folks. The results of the survey convinced the city council to fight for the right-of-way. She's also a member and secretary of the Cupertino Goals Committee in 1981 and secretary of the Multimodal Task Force last year. She's secretary of the West Valley Legislative Committee, and she's also on the board of managers for the Northwest YMCA. And she's also a fundraising member of the Major Donor Committee for Northwest YMCA. So, Barbara, you're a super lady. My applause off to you, out to you. I love you dearly. Thank you. In Cupertino ever since he and his family arrived over 20 years ago. While he has personally kept a very low profile with his community involvement, many hundreds of Cupertino residents have been the beneficiary of his commitment to making his community a better place to live. Among the many public service and community endeavors he has been in are he served as president of the St. Salva Church in Cupertino, and since 1973, he has been the treasurer for the Western Diocese of the Serbian Orthodox Church here in California. He's been a Kiwanis member since 1971, serving on all the standing committees and serving in all officer positions, including president in 1977. In 1980, he was awarded Kiwanian of the Year. Through his service in the Kiwanis Club, he spent many hours with the Senior Citizen Center in Cupertino and the local high schools with the youth and the scouts, the Little League, boys and girls soccer. Spiro's county involvement has been with the Crippled Children's Society in Santa Clara County since 1971. He has been a member on the board of directors since 1979 and has been instrumental in raising funds. One of his special projects is Camp Castanoa. I'm so tongue-tied tonight. The Crippled Children's Camp in Stevens Creek Canyon. Spiro assisted in building an administrator's cabin, painted the counselor's cabins, and did general camp maintenance, as well as finished the construction of a horse barn. Also joining the Cupertino Chamber in 1973, he served on the board of directors as vice president, secretary, treasurer, budget and finance committee, and was our president during the term 1980 and 1981. He has worked on all community projects involving the chamber, as well as being involved with a long-standing history with the U.S. Postal Service. And thank you, Spiro, for being a distinguished citizen of our community. It takes great pleasure for me to present to these two deserving citizens a plaque that really can't say enough. These people have donated thousands of hours to our community to make it a better place to live. Barbara, I would like to present to you a plaque from the Cupertino Chamber of Commerce 1984 Distinguished Citizen Award presented to Barbara Koppel in recognition of outstanding service to the community. I'd like to read your plaque. It's from the Cupertino Chamber of Commerce 1984 Distinguished Citizen Award presented to Spiro Rafalovich in recognition of outstanding service to the community. And this comes with love. And now I'd like to introduce Marie, who will introduce the other presenters for the rest of the program. Marie?
Now I have the honor of introducing our Mayor Phil Johnson.
There are two things really that make this occasion such a special one. The first being that this is always the best group of people ever assembled in this area. And the second is that somehow we always manage to select the best people for this award, and tonight is no exception. Nicole has done a very good job in highlighting their accomplishments, both Barbara's and Spiro's. And I happen to know both of them, and on behalf of the city, it's been a pleasure to work with them and to know them. It's my honor And it's a high point, really, of being mayor to be able to be here tonight and make these presentations to you on behalf of the City Council. And if each one of us could only use their lives and their countless hours of contributions to this community as a goal, we would all each be better off, and certainly this community would be thus more enriched by it. So, Barbara and Spiro, thank you very much. And here are the presentations from the City of Cupertino.
And now from our county, we'd like to have Supervisor Diana McKenna, please come forward. Diana. And also to assist her, our supervisor here, Tom Legan.
One of the joys of being an elected official is the opportunity to meet with the wonderful people of Cupertino and also to honor such fine people like Barbara and Spiro. And I'd just like to tell you that even though the City of Cupertino and the Chamber are recognizing your accomplishments, that we know that what you've done extends far beyond the Cupertino boundaries. So we bring our congratulations from the entire county as well. And rather than read the full resolution that covers many of the accomplishments that I'm going to read Barbara's this evening, and Tom is going to read Spiro's this evening, I'd just like to conclude with the last whereas of the county's resolution that says, whereas Barbara Koppel has performed many public service activities in the community, serving as member and secretary of the Cupertino Goals Committee in 1981, secretary of the Multimodal Task Force in 1983, secretary of the West Valley Legislative Committee, member of the Board of Managers for the Northwest YMCA, and member of the Major Donor Committee for the Northwest YMCA. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the Board of Supervisors of the County of Santa Clara, State of California, hereby extends its congratulations to Barbara Koppel upon her selection as Cupertino's 1984 Citizen of the Year. Thank you.
Well, it's really a thrill for me to be here tonight. Because of my close association with both of these people, I am going to be doing the official presentation from the county for Spiro, but I have to slip in a little word about Barbara. It wasn't a week after she agreed to come to work for me part-time that she was named Cupertino's Citizen of the Year. So I really don't know what to make of that. I think most people's suspicion that the word wasn't out yet. But in any event, I'm very thrilled for Barbara, but I'm particularly thrilled for Spiro because this man inadvertently, I believe, launched my own political career because it was he and Al Carlson, who's here also this evening, Al Carter, excuse me. I'm so tied up with our assessor, you know, making certain we get our money from the county has become such an obsession with me now. His name is on my lips at all time, but Spiro and Al Carter sat on the nominating committee that nominated me to become chamber president of this very chamber back in 1982. And I don't know, time will tell whether that was a wise nomination or not, but Spiro was certainly a role model for me to follow in my own involvement with the chamber. And one dream I know that Spiro has had and does live on with most of us who have been involved in the board of the chamber is that someday we will in fact have our own office that we in fact own. Of course, that's an ambitious undertaking, and the fundraising committee will contact each of you tomorrow as far as our acquisition, but I think someday that is a dream we hope to see come true on behalf of Spiro and the rest of us. But tonight, we're here to honor him for the many involvements and the things he's already given to the chamber, and not unlike the great athlete with which you retire his jersey, I'm here to tell you that Spiro was the last chairman of the board of our Chamber of Commerce, and with that, we retired the jersey, so to speak. But congratulations, Spiro. I'm really thrilled to be here and present you with this resolution of commendation on behalf of the Santa Clara County Board of Supervisors.
Barbara and Spiro, it's a pleasure for me to be here this evening representing the senator, and a real disappointment that she's unable to be here until late today. She planned to be here to do this herself. So it really gives me a great deal of pleasure to be here. I know if she could be here, she would extend to you not only her congratulations, but her thanks to the service you've given to your community, to the county, and also to the state. I have for you each a resolution, and I'm going to read the resolved section of the resolution for you. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the Senate Rules Committee that the members take great pleasure in congratulating Barbara as on her selection as Cupertino Chamber of Commerce Citizen of the Year, applaud her exemplary record of service to and concern for the improvement of her community and state, and extend best wishes for continued success in her future endeavors. And be it resolved that a suitably prepared copy of this resolution be transmitted to Barbara, and I'm doing that tonight. And this is Senate Rules Committee Resolution Number 217, adopted March 5th. Congratulations, Barbara. And for Spiro, now therefore be it resolved by the Senate Rules Committee that the members take great pleasure in congratulating you on Citizen of the Year from the Cupertino Chamber of Commerce, commend your exemplary record of civic participation, and extend sincere best wishes for every success in the future. And this is Senate Resolution Number 222, adopted on March 6th, and congratulations. And thank you.
Yes, we want to meet you. We always have to meet the other half. That's really nice. Thank you. And of course, Bob Koppel, Barbara's husband. And in recognition for all these nice things, we here at the Chamber would like to each of you to have a dozen of these wine glasses with your names inscribed on them, with two decanters, and you'll probably need them, right?
There you go.
Thank you.
The others are here. Yes. Thank you very much, and congratulations to you all. Would you like to say a few words, Barbara and Spiro? After all this?
Actually, I was told to prepare a 20-minute speech, but no, really, I don't have anything prepared. I can't tell you what a great honor this is. I'm overwhelmed. I'm deeply appreciative, and I'm glad it wasn't a surprise because I can't stand running mascara. I know that people went out of their way to be here. I have family from all over, all my five children. You didn't know I had five, but I have five. They're all here. I'd like my family to stand. I can't see you, but I know you're out there. My mother is at the back from Reno. Next to her is my friend who came up yesterday from Southern California, Rose D. Esposito. At the next table is my son, who was right on time, Steve. And his guest, Julie. At the next table is my brother Bob from Reno and his wife Tony. Now I really can't see, but I think the next one is our daughter Debbie from Amsterdam, Holland, who happened to be in the States. Our son Scott, a student at Kennedy. Scott. Our daughter Joy from Southern California. Our daughter Pam from Scotts Valley. And our guest Dan from Kaiser Cement. Hey Dan, go. And my husband Bob. Really, thanks to all of you. I know all my friends and supporters out there and Bob's fellow Rotarians, all the help and support you've given me over the years. The phone calls of, oh God, Koppel, what's our cause this week? I really appreciate it. Thank you very, very much for this honor. Thank you.
I brought a list along because I've got quite a few of my family here, and I would like to just name them. But please hold your applause and let me just name them right down the line. And then afterwards, if you feel like applauding, thank you very much. Now, I have to put my glasses on because I can't see this very well. The young ladies have been telling me tonight that I look very, very nice. I wish they had told me that 20 years ago. You've met my wife. She is the big honcho of the organization. She runs the organization. Yeah. Now then, my daughter Marlene and her husband Donald are here, and then I have two granddaughters, Andriana and Stephanie are here, and my grandson Chep, a very fine young man, and a fellow who wants to go to a prestigious college with a good social program and a good football team. Nothing else matters. My brother Alec and his wife Rosamond, my brother Czar and his wife Edith, my sister Rose and her husband Carl Dubert, my niece, Nancy Dubert Savage, and husband, Mark. And then I have Sophie's nephew, Ted Rafalovich Jr., and his wife, Kim. Now, they live in, the other group lives down south, but Ted and Kim live in Saratoga, and they're the family that has three soccer players at Stanford and a football player at USC. Now, I've been very lucky here in this community, and whatever I've attained has been through luck and through friends. The finest people that I've ever met in the world I've met here in Cupertino, and I can say that very honestly because my wife, who had made a decision many years ago that we were to retire in San Diego, California, after my career in the Postal Service, decided after we'd lived up here a few years, she said, no way, we're gonna stay in the heart of Santa Clara Valley in Cupertino. This is the finest place we can possibly be in. Good. I want to say just a few words about my coming here. One day, what brought me to Cupertino, you know, many people back east, when I traveled through the east with the Post Office Inspectors Organization, every time I'd mention Cupertino, they'd say, where's that and how'd you ever get there? Well, here's what happened to me. In 1959, Postmaster Standish, an old timer in Sunnyvale, drove me down Highway 9 to Saratoga to see the postmaster in Saratoga. And lo and behold, I saw a most beautiful 4 miles of road you ever saw in your life. It was the latter part of April. The blossoms were in bloom on both the apricots and the cherry trees. It was fabulous. I thought to myself, this is really a beautiful place. That was in 59. 1 year later, one of the men who came up with me from Southern California said, I have bought a house in Cupertino. And I said, where is Cupertino? He said, it's midway between Sunnyvale and Saratoga on Highway 9. Oh, I said, I remember that place very well. So I went down with him on a Saturday morning, and the following day I bought a house in Cupertino in 1960, and I've been here ever since. Good. Yeah. Now, in this city of ours, we have a very progressive and aggressive Chamber of Commerce. I've met some very fine people in the chamber here. My work has been fabulous with them. I just enjoyed every minute of it. And also with the Cupertino Kiwanis Club, I'm kind of choked up a little bit, as you can understand. With the Cupertino Kiwanis Club, a very aggressive and progressive club itself. Also with the St. Sava Church, where we have a beautiful tambora orchestra and a lot of fun. So really, the thing that made me a little bit to the value of Cupertino was the fact that there were so many fine people around that I couldn't help but become fairly good at something. And you know, when I stop to think of Cupertino, I've been many places. As a post office inspector, I traveled around the country in many, many, many cities. I wound up in many areas where you wouldn't want to be because of post office thefts and burglaries and robberies. But you know that I never found a community, well, like we have here in Cupertino. We have a brand new community here. We have a community where we have no blighted area. We have no downtown district where the bums hang out. We have a city hall. Yeah. We have had a city government since I've been here. We have had a city government since I've been here in 1960 that has had not one flaw in it. We've had no major problem of any kind. And we can be thankful that we've had good city administration in this city ever since 1960, since I've been here, and possibly long before that. The same thing applies to the Chamber of Commerce. They've been a very good, hardworking organization. And I appreciate Tom, for example, who was there just following me, and then Nicole Lee, and the many others who were in the chamber here. This has been a wonderful community. I'm very thankful that I was permitted to live here. And tonight, I'm overwhelmed with your gratitude. I just feel that whatever I've done was more than worthwhile, and you people are the finest people in the world. Thank you very much. That is a Yugoslav, what you might call a message of goodwill and happiness and many years of a good life and happiness. The Slavs, the Yugoslavs always sing that whenever they're trying to create a good feeling among the people in an audience. Now, the reason I've come back up here, I've done a terrible thing. And here again, you've got to excuse both Barbara and me, because we are very nervous up here, and we should be. But I forgot to introduce my son and his wife, Robert and Mary Rafalovich. Robert, thank you.
Thank you very much.
I'm just so pleased for Barbara and Spiro this evening. And you know, this year the committee deviated from what we traditionally had been done in the past years, and that was announcing the recipients ahead of time instead of waiting to come to the dinner and announcing those recipients here. It was more of a secret in the past years. And you know, the more that the evening goes on and the more I see all these wonderful people and their friends and families, I'm just so very pleased that the committee did this year, and my hat's off to the committee. It was just fantastic. Thank you. It's just really great. In closing, I would like to thank you all so very much for attending, and I would like to thank a few more people, and that is the good thank yous to Gene Thomas of Home Savings America for the band. It's a beautiful band. Wait till you hear them. The City of Cupertino, McWaters, Kaiser Cement, China House Restaurant, Dennis Rieker, Cupertino National Bank and Organization, Rusty Pelican, Barclays Bank, Les Pavillon, McNary Wards, Carl Hovick, Annie Mountain, Sneakers of Northern California, Wiffle Tree Quilts, Cupertino Rotary, Valco Park, Roy Moses, and Celix Formal Wear. I wish to thank you all so very, very much for all your contributions in making this evening a success, and for everyone that is here, and a very special thanks to our secretary, Helen Leahy, who has really done a fantastic job, and Darlene Thorne. Thank you very much for attending, and do enjoy yourself this evening.